hit from power move. A one-time shot, he scores! Another breakaway shot. Goes for the goal. He scores. Rick got it. They score. Seals the deal.
Hello and welcome to Gulls All Access, presented by California Coast Credit Union. I'm your host, Aaron Cooney. Nikita Nesterenko has quickly established himself as an offensive threat for the San Diego Gulls. The Boston College standout has shined in his first AHL season after signing a two-year entry-level contract with the Anaheim Ducks last year. A Brooklyn native and childhood teammate of Ducks star Trevor Zegras, Nikita's decision to sign with the organization was influenced by the opportunity to compete for a position on a NHL roster. Nikita sat down with us to chat about his development and his first professional American Hockey League season.
Nesterenko rips it home on the right side. Nikita Nesterenko with a sneaky shot through some traffic.
Today we're joined by Gulls forward Nikita Nesterenko on the show. Nikita, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
First professional hockey season. Would you believe that you'd be playing professional hockey if you went back and told your five-year-old self this?
Probably not. It's pretty crazy to think about. Yeah, I started playing when I was like four or five, so came a long way. Been a lot of ups and downs, obviously, with all the travel and everything, just a lot of commitment. But yeah, it's, I don't know if I would have believed it, but here we are.
Was this always your dream to become a pro hockey player?
Yeah. Ever since I started, I loved the game, and just my dad put so much time into, you know, helping me with travel and experiencing all the different things, all the different tournaments, Quebec, Edmonton, all those big ones. So I gave a lot of thanks to him, and yeah.
How did you get started playing hockey?
My dad played goalie in Russia. I think he quit when he was like 13, couldn't like really afford it, so he just quit. And then, he just loved the game and then wanted to throw me in it. And started like figure skating a little bit too, just to learn how to skate. And then, just loved it and kept skating, kept practicing, and here we are. And
there aren't a lot of guys who get drafted out of high school hockey. It's a different way. How did that path kind of work for you?
That you were so seen it by enough agents and also scouts and everything to get drafted coming out of high school?
Yeah, I don't know. I've had an interesting path, you know, like not a lot of hockey players in Brooklyn to start off with. I know maybe two that played college, so not many from there. And then just went to a smaller hockey prep school at Lawrenceville, New Jersey. I don't know, I guess a lot of thanks to my agent for doing some work for me and when I was there and talking to different scouts and stuff. But yeah, I don't know, interesting paths, kind of, I don't know how it happened, but just, yeah.
You took a different path instead of, you know, as we mentioned, a lot of guys go junior and you still had to wait to get into Boston College and that start that college career. You play 1 year in the BCHL. Why did you choose to go to the BCHL and play at Chilliwack and you know, you're going a long way from home just to go play hockey?
I talked to a couple teams, the USHL, then BCHL, just kind of seeing what would be a better fit. And I really liked what the coaching staff there in Chilliwack was offering. I liked their play style. And then out there all the way in Vancouver and Chilliwack, it's a great view. You don't really get many chances to go out there and experience that lifestyle. So I thought it'd just be a cool combination, just hockey, good lifestyle. Just went there for a year and it was great, so no regrets.
You go and start your college career, but it's kind of in a weird spot. We talked to Josh Lapine about this too, but you start during the pandemic in 2020. You know, how difficult was that, making that transition where, you know, getting together and being around guys and even playing in empty buildings is kind of the start of your college career?
Yeah, it was a weird time for everyone. I mean, everyone went through it, no matter what league you were in. It's kind of all over the map. So, but yeah, I got lucky enough. Like, we were first in the country, so we had some great players. Like I played with Helly there, met him there. So it's a great group. So I think it made it a lot easier that it was a good group and we were finding ways to win games. So yeah, it was just a weird time for everyone. We were all kind of in together, so made it easier.
What's it like being part of that Boston College-Boston University rivalry?
It was insane. Kind of everyone talks about it, like playing hockey for BC and then for BU, like a big rivalry. But when you're really playing in those games and it's sold out and like fans are cheering, and then there's the bean pot, it's just like such a big rivalry. It stems so many years back. So just to be a part of it for a couple of years was surreal. So
there's only so many players that can say that they played a game outdoors under the lights at Fenway Park. You got to do that. What was that experience like?
Yeah, that was another one. It was anytime you get to play in like a big venue like that, Fenway Park, like so much history there. So, and we won that game, which made it even cooler. So, yeah, it was just a cool experience. One of those like Boston, mega Boston things that you get. So,
While you're there at Boston College, you played for Jerry York, winning his coach in NCAA men's hockey history. What did you learn from him? What did he teach you that you take on today?
Yeah, just his passion for the game. So passionate, you see it. He cares so much about his players. He teaches you how to be a good person off the ice. It's just, we have these little rituals before the practice. It's like there's a quote on a practice plan, and every guy has to read the quote and explain what it means, and just in terms of life and hockey, and just little things like that, like teaching you how to be a professional young athlete. And it's just a legend.
For a couple of Gulls players, it was their first rodeo on a recent road trip to Texas. So, of course, we had to stop by and check out some authentic cowboy apparel.
I would do, like, you know, probably a shirt.
Big belt. I want
a big belt. You have the big belt buckle, then you're going to stand like this, you know, have to, like...
Most important thing is the shoes and the hat.
No, you need some like real cowboy hat. Do you want white? Ale to nie masz, ty masz mać to takto.
Yes.
He's wearing like a hat like this.
Yeah.
You're supposed to have like heaviness.
Then I don't see it.
That's too big.
For summer, it should be good, right?
Take to the beach too?
I hope I can take it to the beach in San Diego, you know? They would think I'm weird, you know? Now with the hat, I'm gonna like confuse them so much, you know? Like where am
who
I?
Who is this
know?
Guy?
And cowboy hat, you know? Accent, like, who is that?
I mean, it's gonna be good sometime to wear it. It was Zach Bryan in concert like 2 months ago.
Looks pretty good, right?
Like that one?
Looks pretty good.
Where you're from?
Yeah, I'm from Czech Republic.
Uh-huh.
He's from Slovakia.
Slovakia?
Yeah.
Go back home, you're gonna be going
yeehaw. Oh, yeah. Riding on a horse, yeah. It's pretty big on me. A small cowboy, I guess.
He has no style.
Stop. You need to put a better outfit so Rich is not this cocky, you know? You need to do something about it.
Oh. Okay, let's do the outfit. I have an idea in my head now.
What do you think so far about this outfit?
I like that, boss.
Am I gonna look like a real cowboy?
Huh?
I was watching a TV show like that.
Now you can go to Cowboys and then. Now I look like Roy Sommer.
He put it on like a necklace.
Okay, we need to do who is looking better.
No, we have to do like photo like this.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Goose fans, thank you for joining us here. Hope you guys enjoyed like we did. And see you soon in San Diego.
Coming up, Pavol Regenda is mic'd up for rivalry night against the Ontario Reign, right here on Gulls All Access, presented by California Coast Credit Union.
Yeah! Woo! Yes, sir! That's it!
Join us on March 16th as we celebrate St. Patrick's Day versus the Milwaukee Admirals at 6 p.m. Enjoy a pregame tailgate starting at 4 p.m. featuring Irish dancers, green beer, mouth-watering food, $8 Blue Line Blonde Ales, and so much more. The first 8,000 fans in attendance will receive a free Gulls Scally cap. Secure your seats now at sandiegogulls.com/tickets.
And now Pavol Regenda takes us on the ice for rivalry night against the Ontario Reign in this edition of Gulls Mic'd Up.
Oh, Black, let's go, Black! Let's go, boys, let's go, boys! Yeah, yeah, yeah! Yeah, yeah! Play, 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 play! That was right behind you, between the dots. It's okay, it's okay. Joe Becky. Hey! Hey! What do you do? Okay, I'll give you a hard bump here. Skate over. Aggie, Aggie! Yeah, yeah! Belly, yeah!
In the slot, he scores!
That's it, that's it, that's it. Hey, good job. Hey. Let's see, what are we talking about? Net, net, net!
The San Diego Gulls take pride in giving back to San Diego and the Southern California communities. Here's a recap of some of the organization's recent community involvement.
We're here today at the first Women's Try Hockey for Free Clinic at Poway Ice. So the women here today, there's all different levels who are showing up for this. Some people have never tried it all before, so you know, we're doing everything from learning how to get up today, puck handling, stick handling, scoring, hopefully, and just everything that comes with having to play a game of hockey.
Having all these women come out and try hockey for the first time and be able to experience that is so special. And as a sport with a somewhat high barrier to entry, with all the different gear you have to have, the limited ice time that's available, having programs like this is something that is so special and super important to the hockey community here in San Diego.
Hockey position, what we want to see, our knees bent, butts down, chest up, and head up, okay?
The goal really was to get a lot of people who normally wouldn't have tried it, maybe they're afraid of the co-ed experience, and it is a little overwhelming, so giving them the opportunity to get out here today, try it with a bunch of other women who have never done it for the first time, and see if they like it and really give them the opportunity to play hockey.
Good work. Okay, same thing. I want to see that same thing, but with the opposite leg, okay? Go ahead on back.
So it's definitely something that ties in very well with Women in Sports Night. It's our second annual one, and this year, Haley Meyer and I were kind of brainstorming on how to add new aspects into it and just build upon last year's amazing event. And we came up with this.
Really good job, you guys. Really good job.
I'm so impressed with the women here today. They're just absolutely crushing it. I know it can be kind of intimidating to come out here and try something new and put new gear on, but they're really doing a great job. And I think I've seen improvement in the hour that we've been here, so they're doing great.
A few Gulls players recently had the opportunity to swing by Rady Children's Hospital and hang out with some young fans.
We're just here to visit some of the kids that are here and just really trying to put a smile on their face. Obviously, they're going through rough times, and you know, it's easy for us to come just say hi and spend some time with them. It's awesome to see them come out here with a smile and, you know, everything that some of them are going through, and it just makes our day even brighter. So just to see them smile and we're able to make them smile, it's, you know, it's great.
We come here and hopefully we make them laugh, you know, make them happier. So, you know, that's something we can get back. So, you know, happy to be here and, you know, and see those kids and like have a little talk with them, you know, and hopefully we make them laugh, you know, make them happier. So, you know, that's something we can get back. So, we're happy to be here and see those kids and like have a little talk with them, you know, make them laugh a little bit, you know, hopefully they're happy to see us and trying to do a good thing.
It's always great working with Rady Children's Hospital. They're one of our closest community partners and, you know, it's a real relationship where we help them, they help us. We like to make all their patients here, whether they're from San Diego or just visiting for treatment, really feel like they're part of our San Diego family.
First and foremost, probably the most important thing that we do is giving back to the community, but especially in certain areas like this. We get to play a sport for a living and pretty much wake up every morning and have fun. And like I said, it just gives you a new perspective. It gives you more of an appreciation. And it's awesome that the Gulls do this, do multiple events like this. And I think it just goes to show the character organization that we have here. But it's a treat coming to places like this and just seeing some of these kids and being able to put a smile on their face and joke with them a little bit for even if it's just a couple minutes during the day.
Patrons of a local San Diego Soapy Joe's car wash were in for a big surprise to find Gulls players handing out rally towels and t-shirts. Soapy Joe's is the official car wash of the San Diego Gulls and the sponsor of the Gulls Ice Crew for all home games at Pechanga Arena. Gulliver and the players took time to take photos with fans and even participated in a friendly car detailing competition. Recently, Gulls forwards Chase DeLeo and Andrew Agazino were able to participate in Reading is the Goal. Reading is the Goal is a free program open to elementary school grade classrooms in the greater San Diego area.
My name is Chase DeLeo, and I'm very excited to read Z is for Zamboni by Matt Napier with you today. Now, N stands for numbers, some famous ones you'll see. There's number 9 for Gordie Howe and 99 for Gretzky.
The organization coordinates directly with school district leadership, principals, and teachers to encourage classrooms to sign up and participate and encourage reading with the chance to win exciting Gulls prizes.
And by the end of practice, he was sailing up and down the ice in his hand-me-down skates.
The players were recorded reading their favorite hockey-themed children's books, with those videos to be distributed to participating classrooms.
I really enjoyed reading with you all today. Thank you for joining me and making reading your goal. Have a great day.
Coming up, we have part two of our sit-down with Nikita Nesterenko, right here on Gulls All Access, presented by California Coast Credit Union.
San Diego Gulls Bowling Night is back. Join your favorite Gulls players this Sunday, March 10th, for San Diego Gulls Bowling Night, brought to you by Best Pizza and Brew, from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. at Mira Mesa Lanes, for a night filled with fun, raffles, and friendly competition. All proceeds benefit the San Diego Gulls Foundation. Only a few spots remain, so act now. Visit sandiegogulls.com/bowling to secure your lane today.
And now part two of our interview with forward Nikita Nesterenko.
Nesterenko charges to the zone and rips it home.
Nikita, drafted by Minnesota, and before you take your first steps onto an NHL ice sheet, you're traded to the Anaheim Ducks. What is that moment like to be traded?
Yeah, it was weird. I was actually taking a nap before one of my games. That was during the last day of the deadline, I remember last year. Yeah, it was interesting. You know, you work so hard with the team that drafted you, like over the years with their developmental coaches, and just kind of finishing up your game, rounding it out, and then you get traded, and then it's a whole new experience, whole new staff. It was interesting, but just like anything else, you adjust and then you move on.
And it must have been a wild march. I mean, traded, signed, and then a few days later, you're flying out to California to make your NHL debut. You know, what's going through your head as you're going to step onto the ice and have that debut against the Calgary Flames? You get the rookie lap and everything. What's going through your head?
Yeah, I mean, you're not really thinking at that point. You're kind of just getting on the plane, going, kind of just talking to everyone, getting to meet people, all the great players and staff, and just taking in everything you can, kind of soaking it in. And yeah, it was just a whirlwind of events, but you're kind of just trying to stay level-headed and just kind of take in as much information as you can because there's so many great tools out there. And I played with Trev, Mid-Fairfield Rangers, when we were maybe 11 or 12. So comes full circle. He was one of the first guys that reached out, so that was comforting. And yeah, he's an unbelievable player. So just to have a guy like that on your side along the way is pretty cool and, yeah, lucky.
That people don't even realize he has. Here's McTavish, great pass, and Nesterenko has his first NHL goal.
2 games after your NHL debut, you score your first National Hockey League goal. Take me through that moment. What was it like?
I think I was on the ice with Terry and McTavish that shift. So two pretty good players, I'd say. Terry made a great play, gave it out to Mac T in the slot, and then I kind of just presented my stick back door and I had a wide open cage. So just put it in, and then, it was a cool experience, like being on the ice with those guys especially, and then at home too at Honda Center. So, yeah.
Did you know much about the Southern California kind of hockey world? Were you surprised at all by what, you know, the fans of Pechanga Arena, what San Diego and this fan base can bring on a nightly basis?
Yeah, definitely surprised me a little bit. I didn't think hockey was big in California at all. It's definitely, I would say it's more popular on the East Coast, but I came to San Diego, first game in Pechanga, it's packed house. You're like, what's going on? So yeah, it's definitely one of the coolest fan bases I've played in front of. You know, even when we don't have as much success, they're still as passionate and still showing up as when you're having a lot of success. So, you know, you dream of like playing in front of big crowds and, you know, scoring in front of big crowds. So when you're at home and you score a big goal and the place erupts, like, there's no feeling like you get the goosebumps, the fans are going, the bench is up. It's something you dream of for sure.
That'll do it for this episode. Join us next time when we hit the golf course for an off-day tournament with some of the players. I'm Aaron Cooney. Thanks for watching Gulls All Access, presented by California Coast Credit Union.